Aloha, everybody. Welcome to this episode of FishNGrillz. We're here with Long Run and Spices. They're going to show us how to make some delicious fish dishes. What do we have here?
So we have stuffed pepper taco, fried fish taco, fish quesadilla, ceviche, and taco taco.
And these will be so delicious. Hope everybody sticks around. Everybody,
stay tuned.
And
for this episode of
FishNGrillz!
Hello everybody, thanks for tuning in. We have a special collab with our friends from La Morena. They flying down, we took some fish out of the stash. We're gonna prep it all up, hand it off to them, see what we got cooking up tonight. Stick around. Speaking of La Morena, look who just pulled up.
Hey,
what's up?
Nice to see you guys.
What's up?
How's it, bro?
Nice to see you.
Hi.
Hi, how are you? With tomatoes, onions, jalapenos, and some cilantro. And then we're also going to be making a slaw for our fish tacos today with the two types of cabbage, lime, cilantro, carrots, and of course, our seasoning. Cut up some veggies for the ceviche to soak in with the lemon juice, and then after that's done cooking in the lemon juice, we're gonna drain it and add some other vegetables to it. So here we go. Let me get these super thin slices. Then you can just cut them again. And the garlic.
All right, now we're gonna add some salt just to kind of pull out that extra moisture and make everything all nice.
Thank you.
dinner bell.
Dinner bell.
In your water.
That's not, I'm trying to get that
so
girl.
Pork pie and pepper first.
Yeah.
Oh, school yarn.
Yeah.
Which is like a soup base. And then we add our veggies. And that's gonna make our salsa.
Let's see what's going on over here.
So this is gonna be for the tacos.
For the tacos, they want 1-inch length, skinny. They said they want it small because the beer batter stretches, so they want it as small as possible to fit right in the tortillas.
Oh, bingo.
Bingo.
Yeah. Can I see the bowl? Not much.
That's good.
We got this beautiful blue dot grouper, aka the Roy. Fillet it up. Into the tacos we go.
Burp taco.
If you're not affected, check the link in our bio. It's available right now for purchase.
Everything's chopped up, so now we're ready to season it. We're gonna add a little bit of our garlic pot pie and our all-purpose seasoning. And then just mix it all up. The bowl's too small. So we're gonna season the fish for the fish tacos with our garlic pot pie. Then you just mix mess it up. Make sure it's all coated.
Honey, you want some? Some
good egg garlic.
Yeah.
She's one of the staff tea sisters.
And you can do it to your liking, so you can put as little or as much seasoning as you want. And this is when you take the time to find bones. Or whatever.
Oops, Chev, you left a bone.
No, I'm just kidding.
I left what?
Left a bone.
Oh, shit.
That's okay. There, that should be good. So it's all nice and coated. So I'm going to season this steak with our Paniolo barbecue rub. It's a coffee style barbecue rub with Kauai coffee. We're just going to go ahead and go a little heavy on it. And you can go heavy on it because it's not salty. So you're just going to get lots of good flavor and you don't have to worry about it being too salty. And we're going to use this steak to stuff these chilies with cheese.
Honey, you want to smell?
So we're going to clean out all the stuff from these chilies and we're going to stuff them with cheese and that steak we seasoned a little bit ago. Split it in a tea, then you just crack it open. Cut the seed pod out. And there you go. We're going to give them a rinse to get all that stuff out before we stuff them. Oh.
So this is for the ceviche. Ceviche, this is the nenui dices. Real thin. They already have the sauce pre-made.
Are you cheating on us? What kind of, who made that fish?
Who makes that? No, I make that.
Fridge so it can get nice and cool and it can finish cooking with the lemon juice. So now I'm gonna make the filling for the peppers and we're gonna mix cream cheese. I left it out so it's soft and it's easier to mix. And we're gonna add a little bit of cheese. You can use any kind of cheese. I use quesadilla cheese, you can use Monterey Jack cheese, you can use cheddar cheese, but since we're doing steak, I like a nice white cheese. And then, because we're about that season life, we're gonna use our Paniolo rub, just like the steak. And we're just gonna add that in there, like that.
Dig in.
So before we blend up our salsa, we need to peel the skin off the tomatoes. You don't have to, but you don't want like pieces of skin in your salsa, so it just makes it smoother in the end when you're done. And I'll just gotta peel it. Okay, so we have all of our stuff ready, and because we don't know how hot these are gonna be just yet, we're gonna take one out and add it in a little while. And we're gonna season it with garlic pot kai, just a little bit. And then the house bouillon is what's really gonna set off that salsa. Our house bouillon is basically like a vegan chicken soup base. tastes like chicken, but there's no actual chicken. And then we reserved some of the water that we boiled all this stuff in, and we're gonna just add a little bit in to get it going. And then we blend. I might put some in the blender.
Okay.
So now's a good time for you to try it and see if it needs anything right now. It needs a little bit more salt. So I'm going to use the garlic pot kai. And I'm going to add a little bit more of our house bouillon.
All right, looks like the fire's getting started. Stir it up.
Joanne, are you really cooking the salsa?
Yeah, so whenever you cook it, it just preserves it longer, and it also takes any like acidity or bitterness out of the tomato. So once you cook it, you can use it, store it in the fridge for a week, if not longer, when you just don't, it just doesn't stay as long. But what you can also do is get the chips and the salsa tomorrow if you have leftover, and put just a little bit of oil, and you cook down the salsa a little bit, and you add the chips, and you crack an egg, and you put a lid on top.
Oh yeah.
And it just makes chilaquiles, and they're so good.
How do you say it?
Chilaquiles.
Chilaquiles.
Yeah, so it's basically a fried tortilla chip with salsa and egg, and you can add cheese or sour cream or whatever on top. It's the best breakfast after hangover even.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's great.
Yummy, yummy.
So what we're making now is the ceviche has been marinating in the fridge, and so now we're gonna make all of these chopped vegetables, which is basically like a pico de gallo, which is tomato, onion, cilantro, and we're gonna mix it with the fish once it's done cooking. And that's it.
Right on, boy!
The taco dance!
Right on! Oh, too big to hit, I think so.
Oh, that's a fatty, bro.
I need a...
Oh, that's a big one, fat head. Okay. No, not again.
Okay. Let me see.
Yeah, the first.
Oh, you got him, you got him, you got him, you got him. There you go. Let me see.
Like a four pounder. Okay, as you got done cleaning a taco, we're gonna put it in a pressure cooker. Then we're gonna grill it for a nice char. Then we're gonna make some taco tacos. Stay tuned.
Sample.
A little bit at a time.
Take a dip, take a sip.
A little spice. We need to throw that jalapeno.
You want the other jalapeno?
Yeah, let's do it.
A little more kick.
A little bit more kick, bro. Okay. A little more kick.
Kick. Yeah, kick sounds good.
So it wasn't hot enough. So what we're gonna do is add the jalapeno with a little bit more of that salsa. We're gonna just add it right back into here, just to have something to mix it with.
You have one whole pepper? Or?
Yeah, the whole one.
So we're here having is a pressure cooker. We got our tacos. We're gonna put inside. About 15 minutes. Then we're gonna throw it on a grill to char it up. Put it in some tortillas. Tacos in sesh. All right, I have this fish I just filleted. I have some trigger fish, some polani, some poalus, some mackerels. I don't know what to do with this.
So what I think we could do is make a foil pocket with onion, cilantro, and maybe a little bit of jalapeno. And we can use our brand new seasoning that's not out yet. Nobody's tried it.
Okay then.
So we got our fish and we have cilantro, we have jalapeno and onions, and we're just gonna throw all of that in there along with our new seasoning.
Ooh, the new secret seasoning. Stay tuned to find out what it is in this.
We don't have a name yet.
Yeah, so there you go.
It's still in development, so I'm just gonna like give this a good mix. Get it all nice and coated.
Yep, seen it here on FishNGrillz.
So it needs a little bit more. So the good thing about our seasonings is that you can go heavy on the seasoning and get lots of good flavor without having to worry about ever being salty. Because we use the Alaea salt, it's really low in sodium, has lots of beneficial minerals, and you don't have to worry about high blood pressure, any of that nonsense. And it's all clean ingredients. Some of our stuff is locally sourced, so you're supporting our local farmers when you buy from us as well. And that's it. So now we're gonna just put it in a foil pouch and let it sit on the grill and get nice and smoky. And then stay tuned to see what we do with it after it's done. So we're gonna fold it over and then fold over this side. And we're gonna seal it, make a nice pocket.
Wow, so fast, so cool.
And then you just stick it on the grill like that.
Sonny, you okay with it?
Yes, let's go, let's go.
Again. Ooh, that smells good.
That's it.
All right. Hey, by the way, it's Chev's birthday today.
Get him.
Oh, man.
Happy
birthday, boy! Happy birthday, son. Thank you,
Mom. Love you.
Hey, let me get some of that out of here.
Ah!
Oh,
no!
Can't eat!
So now we're getting the cheese mixture that we made earlier, and we're gonna stuff our peppers with the cheese. Just kind of make sure it's all pushed down in there. And once the steak is ready, we're gonna chop it up and put it on here, and then it's gonna go back on the grill. And you can use as little as much as you want, but remember, cheese melts and it's gonna spill over, so you don't wanna overstuff it either.
Double stub.
So, I'm just gonna cut around the fat just for now, but we're still gonna use it. We want tiny, tiny pieces.
Just gonna borrow one of these. Yep, I approve.
Roll the B-roll.
Oh, breathe, inhale, outhale, let's do it together.
I remember my first time for you. Oh, honey.
Honey girl.
It's okay, honey.
Here, honey girl.
Oh, there you go.
You guys be feeding her autographs, you know?
Bruh, she's good.
She better than me sometimes.
Taste tester approved?
Of course.
Mmm. Very good. Nice balance of salt flavor.
Oh yeah, it's the Paniolo rub.
You go, girl. That's gonna be your tastiest bowl. So we want to get this as small as possible so we're able to stuff them in the chilies. So if you have a meat cleaver, great. If not, just keep chopping until it gets super small. And this is about the size that you want it. So now we're ready to stuff it. Just grab this, put it right in there.
It's gonna expand too, yeah? Or...
Yeah.
But the cheese, I guess.
The cheese, well, because I mixed it with the cream cheese, so it's not gonna get too melty, but it's gonna get melty.
All right, so our taco's been here for about 15 minutes. I'm gonna release the pressure.
So normally a taco would take maybe half an hour up to an hour to cook in the soft cooker. 15 minutes. You're gonna put it on the grill, fire it up, tacos, tacos.
Oh, that thing is soft.
Minutes, and look how soft this is. Straight through. Okay, heading to the grill.
Don't do that.
What's going on? Okay.
Taco.
Can I season them first before
you put it on? You sure can. What? So she wants to season them first with some special seasoning before we put this on the grill.
So we have the pockets that we made earlier. This is what it looks like.
Oh!
Nice and steamy.
So steamy.
Here's the other one.
Oh. Can I just eat one of those?
Yeah, go for it.
Oh, okay. What fish is this?
A mix.
this is
it's a mystery.
It's a variety.
Mystery.
Cheers, happy birthday. I don't think the camera fits that way. But that is delicious.
That's delicious. That's so good. Fish and chips, bro.
Fish and chips.
You can probably leave
hey,
one like
I got this, guys.
That's secret sauce is.
Oh. That's the new secret.
Oh.
I don't have a name for
taste
it.
Taste oh. Sensor.
The unnamed.
It's unnamed.
Bro, oh, so good.
Hey!
Why don't sing?
Okay, I'm just gonna mute the audio on this, put music.
Yeah.
Put some sex music in the background.
Oh my god, that's so good.
Edit. Oh, Sonny, save yourself for the rest of us. It's so good though.
So usually I would like to warm these up first, but since they're going on the grill, you don't need to. We're gonna start by putting it down, put a little cheese first, and then some fish.
The good stuff.
And then we're gonna put more cheese on top. Then you close it up. Put more on top.
Oh, there it is.
Salsa in there. And then you put it on the grill.
Oh,
ready
okay.
To go?
So, gotta wait a little bit. Okay. The anticipation.
Right on the grill.
Ooh, next to those stuffed peppers. All right.
The trick to a good beer batter is to have the beer and the whisk super cold. So you're gonna put flour. There's no measurement, just flour. I'm gonna add a little bit of cornstarch just to get it crispy. And then all-purpose seasoning. Just go in there. And then we're gonna add the beer.
So beer.
We're gonna have el guapo, and it's agave, lime, and cilantro, so it's gonna go perfect with the fish tacos. And you just add a little at a time.
Yummy, soon to be in my tummy. Yep.
You want it like a pancake consistency. You want it kind of thick so it can stick on the fish. Just Perfect. So we put toothpicks in there just so that the toothpicks burn and not the oil, because you don't want the oil to burn or have that nasty taste. So then we get your fish, dip it in.
This is the first one of the beer batter. Just flour, cornstarch, and some seasoning. Deep fried, golden brown. A lot of flavor, perfect crunch to it, perfect texture. Delicious. Oh. Besides the heat, is it good?
Yes, sir.
Oh, it's still hot.
Oh, yeah. So that's all done. We're going to season up the taco. And we're going to do taco on taco.
Taco on taco.
So here we go. We're just going to season it real nice. We just. That's it. Then it's all nice and seasoned. We're gonna walk it over.
All prep, ready to go.
Good to go.
Drop it on there.
Woo! Smells good right off the bat.
There you go. We're gonna let that cook for a little bit, and then we'll chop it up and put in tacos.
Sounds good.
Tacos.
All right, that's it.
All right, our taco is all charred up. Let's get her in the pan. Soft and charred, ready to go. And we're just hitting up the, what is this?
Tortillas.
Tortillas. Hitting up the tortillas. Then we're gonna have one more batch. She's making the last batch right here.
I'm ready.
She's ready to go. And this is the roy that we filleted up earlier. Nice pink meat. Get this fire started again. Thank you again for joining us today. Thank you, Lamarna and Spicy, for coming out and making my birthday even more special. We had a blast.
Thank you so much for having us. It's been so great.
We had some good times and grinds, good people.
As always, stay tuned for the next episode of
FishNGrillz!